Today's topic for the lecture is acute diarrheal diseases. So in the context of the acute diarrheal diseases, we will be discussing epidemiology and prevention and control of the acute diarrheal diseases. What are the preventive strategy, how we treat the diarrheal diseases in children to prevent the dehydration, because basically the dehydration it is the cause for the mortality. So before discussing the actual topic, just I would like to tell you, as per NMC guideline, we have started family adoption program from the GMC Community Medicine Department of GMC Haldwani, and it was started since February 2022. Now we also have prepared our logbook as per NMC guideline family adoption program, and it was launched on the 4th of July. With the support of the principal, Mr. Arun Joshi, sir. And now it is ready for the student. It is started from the batch 2021. Okay? So, and the students can take this manual from the community medicine department. And now it is ready for the work. Now, the main topic is the acute diarrheal diseases. So, anybody can define the diarrhea? Anybody? Any student can define the diarrhea? आपकी posting pediatrics में चल रही है ना? चल रही है? कौन सा batch है pediatrics में? So this topic will cover the objective according to your competency, because it is a competency based curriculum. So it will cover the objective 3.3, 7.2, 8.1 and 8.4, which include the etiology and what are the basis of the diarrheal diseases, and it will enumerate, describe, discuss the mode of the transmission and measures for the prevention and control of the acute diarrheal diseases. And we will describe and discuss the control measures and what are the principles, and enumerate the measures to control of the acute diarrheal diseases epidemic. So now the definition, how we will define the diarrhea. So diarrhea, basically it is a passage of loose stool, liquid or watery stool. And the frequency, if we say the frequency, it may be the more than 3 times a day. But actually it is not hard and fast the frequency, because usually some person having the 2 times in a day or 3 or 1 times a day, it is basically the consistency or recent change in the character of the stool. Which the individual can say, now there is some change in the consistency and the character of the stool and something wrong. Maybe I have the loose stool or diarrhea or. And even the mother can tell. Mother, if you go visit in the family visit, the mother can tell ki doctor sahab, mera bachcha kal tak to theek tha, aaj uska stool jo hai kuch diarrhea jo hai stool patla ho raha hai, consistency patla ho raha hai. Even mother can tell the ki now it is a something wrong, and you can assess that it may be the diarrhea. And we know the worldwide acute diarrheal disease, it is the second leading cause for the death of the children under 5 years of age. And if we see the scenario in India, it is approximately in 1980 4.6 million used to die each year because of the dehydration of the diarrhea. And now, because of the diarrheal disease control program, availability of the ORS and availability of the fluid therapy, now the death is remarkably decreased. Mortality now it decreased due to the diarrhea, although the not much consideration change in the incidence. Incidence is, because for any disease we calculate the how much the new cases are occurring, and that is very important to measure the how much disease is the fatal. The okay, diarrhea is occurring, but the mortality now is decreased considerably because of availability of the good rehydration therapy and the knowledge of the mothers and knowledge of the NM field staff worker, they know how to provide the full therapy. So we considerably decrease in the mortality. In spite of that, it is account for 10% of the death in under 5 years of age, and 12.92 million cases and death is 1,331 death were reported in India. So how we classify the diarrhea? So according to the, we have the four classification: acute diarrhea, acute when it is a sudden occurrence of the diarrhea, change in the consistency and character of the stool, increase in the frequency, it can persist up to the days, 1 week, or it can resolve within the 10 days or 14 days, less than 10 days, and it can lead to the dehydration and weight loss, and usually it is occurred by the Vibrio cholerae and E. coli, causes the watery diarrhea, and acute bloody diarrhea known as the dysentery, and it causes the damage in the intestinal mucosa. So it causes the invasive diarrhea which can lead to the blood in the stool, and it